Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain use of break and continue keywords in loop. So I will be implementing these uses in C programming. So before starting, if you go to detail and description of this video, you will find links of various playlists. So you can watch them to learn programming. Now coming on to the topic. So first I'm going to explain the use of break, and then we will see the continue keyword. So if we talk about break, so break is used to terminate execution of loop. So if you are using break inside loop, then it can terminate execution cycle of the loop, right? So now let's see how it works. So right now I am implementing a for loop, but you can use this break keyword with any loop. Maybe it is for, maybe it is while, or maybe it is do while. So let's say here I am writing backslash n percent d, and I am going to print value of I. Then if I double equals to 3, then I am writing break, and after this if block I am writing inside loop. So here you can see this if is having only break because curly braces are not there. So if we don't use curly braces, it means if will have only one statement with it, and this printf is not associated with if. Now I'm going to repeat this loop. It will start from one, check its condition, so it is true, then value of I will be printed, that is one. Now check this if condition, so it is false, so this break will not work right now, so control will be transferred here, so inside loop will be printed. Then I plus plus takes place, so I will become two, so two will be printed. Again condition is false, so inside loop will be printed. Then I plus plus, I will become 3. Now first I will be printed as 3, then this condition will become true, so I is 3, so 3 double equals to 3 is true, so break will work. So as I told you, break is used to terminate execution of loop. So whenever control goes to break, from here onwards loop will not execute anything and control will be transferred outside. So this will be the output if we are using or we are writing this code. So I hope you understood the use of break. So if you want to break execution of loop at a particular point of time, then you can implement this keyword. And is irrespective of the loop, it can be for loop, it can be while loop, or it can be do while. So you can implement break with any kind of loop. So I hope you understood this implementation and the use of break. Now coming on to continue. So if we talk about continue, so continue is having different nature as compared to break. So this is continue keyword. So it's it skips rotation of loop. So it don't terminate, it just skips rotation cycle of the loop. So let's see how it works. So here I'm writing this, and let's say if is written with continue, so again if is not having any curly braces, so this will repeat only. So with this logic, rotation, only one rotation will be skipped. So first I am going to tell you how you can skip one rotation, then I will tell you how you can skip more than one rotations, right? So starting from here, one, then condition is true, one will be printed. Check this condition, it is false, so control will be here, so we can print inside loop, then I will become 2. So 2 will be printed, condition is false. So again, inside loop will be printed. Then it will be 3. So 3 will be printed. Now this time, if condition is true, so we are on continue. So from here, control will be transferred to increment part once, because right now this condition is true. So I will become 4 and this will not be printed. This inside loop one time is skipped. So whatever is written after continue, if continue is executing, so whatever is written after continue won't execute. So I will become 4. So 4 will be printed. Now check this condition. It is false. So this time it will be printed. And then I will become 5. So 5 and inside loop will be printed again, because 5 is not equal to 3. So continue will not execute. So in this scenario, continue executed once. So only one rotation was skipped. So this I hope you understood. Now I will tell you how we can skip more than one rotation. So let's say I'm using this. If I modulus 2 double equals to 0, then only we need to use this keyword continue. We need to execute this keyword continue. So it means if I is even, then continue will work, otherwise not. So again, starting from the beginning, I is 1, condition is true, so 1 will be printed. 1 modulus 2, so 1 modulus 2 is not equals to 0, so it is false. So inside loop will be printed, so it will print as it is. Then I will become 2, 2 will be printed. Now 2 modulus 2, remainder is 0, so continue will execute. So this will be skipped. So when I is having even value, then inside loop will not be printed. Then I will become 3. 3 will be printed. 3 modulus 2. So 3 modulus 2 remainder is not 0. So this time continue will not work and this will print. So when we have value as 3, so inside loop will print. Then I will become 4. So 4 will be printed. 4 modulus 2. So this time again it is equals to 0. So continue will work and control will transfer here. It will not execute. So in case of 4, inside loop will not print. I will become 5. So 5 will be printed. And 5 modulus 2 remainder is not 0. So continue will not work and inside loop will print. So you can see only in case of odd numbers, both digit and inside loop are printed. In case of 2 and 4, only digits are printed. This message is not printed. So this way you saw how we skip multiple rotations or more than one rotations of loop with the help of continue. So whenever control reaches to continue, whatever is written after continue statement won't work. It skips that particular rotation. So this is the use of continue. So use it properly. Because with the help of break and continue, you are doing some extra functioning while implementing the loops. So if you use break and continue, then your loop is having additional features. So use them carefully so that your output will be correct. So I hope you understood how we can use break and continue with loops in C programming. So if you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel, go to playlist, and there you will find more than 1000 videos related to programming. So do watch them, and I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this video.